Her two-person at NASA paid a visit to Northeast Ohio today. She was in town to get caught up on the progress of several projects at NASA Glenn. As News Channel 5's John Kosick tells us, those projects have impact beyond space.
Tucked off a parking lot on NASA Glenn's sprawling 350-acre campus sits a small, almost garage-like building with an equally indescript name, Cell 32. But what they're testing inside could change the way rocket engines are made in the future. Instead of an injector made up of about 50 tiny elements, they're testing an advanced manufacturing process that made what is essentially a two-piece product.
It's 25% of the original cost and time that it took originally to make these large injectors.
It's something that will benefit NASA, but also the way jet engines as a whole are made. It's one of the projects that Deputy Administrator Lori Garver came to Cleveland from Washington to see. The others including cryogenic propellant systems and solar electric propulsion technologies. High-tech stuff that will help NASA in its mission, yes, but will also eventually lower the cost for businesses like the multi-billion dollar communications satellite industry.
That's an investment that NASA makes that will return to this economy immeasurably.
That's something she learned from Ohio Senator John Glenn. You see, Carver worked for Glenn right out of college and learned a lot from the man whose name now adorns his facility.
John Glenn said it 1,000 times if he said it once. R&D investment in NASA is the seed corn for our future. And I really think that just is as true today as it was then.
In Brook Park, John Kosick, News Channel 5.